Live from Shadowmere Studios, it's Talkie Box. Viewer discretion is advised.
Absolutely is advised.
Right?
Yeah.
Especially now that they can see us.
Yeah, that's probably the worst idea.
I don't know why we did this.
I don't know. Yeah. I feel like last time we didn't even introduce ourselves.
No. I don't know if we did or not.
I'm your host, Dave. With me, as usual, is Jason.
I'm Jason.
And Justin.
Hi.
And tonight we have a newcomer, Destiny.
Hello.
Who's going to tell us all about herself.
Oh, great.
Starting from the birth canal.
Yeah.
Okay.
What part of that do you remember?
All of it. It was all very traumatic, but I try to block it out.
Yeah.
Vivid detail.
We're going to need all the details.
Traumatic. No, I am this guy's sister.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Related.
Yep.
Same mom, same dad?
Yes.
Yep. All right. So yes. Full-on brother-sister.
Full-on.
Full
yes.
Right on. Full-on brother-sister.
Full-blown siblings.
Yep. 100%.
Right on. No halvesies, no quarterlies, no steps.
It's funny. There's this debate that always goes around when people find out that we're related. And it always seems to be down the line. Half people think we look alike and they can tell that we're related. And then other people say we look absolutely nothing alike and they can't tell that we're related.
Yeah.
I think you have similar coloring.
Similar
we have
color.
The same hair color.
Like the same color palette, I think.
Yeah. I mean, that's yeah.
I was told that I looked too white to be related to Justin.
That was a real thing that happened. When we worked together, somebody found out that we were brother and sister and said, she's your sister? I'm like, yeah, like, that's so weird. She's so white. And I'm like, I don't know.
Like, I mean, you do you come across me? Well, you've got a little bit of an ethnicity.
Is it because of the beard?
No.
Is it the beard?
I think it's the lips.
I was being facetious.
I don't think you had the beard back then when y'all worked together, did you?
I did. It just wasn't as
pronounced.
Bushy, yeah.
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 Huh.
See, my brother and I, we have different dads, but we look absolutely nothing alike. Like, Jason knows my brother.
Yep.
And most people, when they find out that we're related, they're like, no, you're not.
No.
There's no possible way. Nothing alike. And then they hear us talk to each other like, oh,
y'all are definitely
related. Mm-hmm. Like, you are both assholes.
Yeah. there's just something about, like, that sibling assholery that just really, it's unique. It's unique to siblings.
I have a gorgeous half-sister, and she looks nothing like me.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, I precursored it with gorgeous so everyone would know.
Yeah, yep. obviously.
It seemed like a little bit of a redundant statement.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah, that occurred. She exists. And she's cooler than I am.
Weird story about Jason's sister, actually, is that so she lives in Singapore, right?
The Thailand.
Woo! For real?
Yep. And I have a friend that I used to work with years ago who now lives in the same area and became friends with Jason's sister.
What?
Like, out of nowhere, I just happened to be on Facebook and I saw, like, this person knows this person. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me?
That's like two small world stuff.
Yeah, it's
like,
really just small world, but at the same time, how many English-speaking people live in Singapore?
Probably a lot, to be honest.
Probably a lot, but at the same time, out of all of the English-speaking people, I feel like that definitely cut the odds in their favor a little bit.
Mm. Yeah, and especially since they're both from Georgia. They're both, you know, they're both from relatively close, same area, like Gwinnett County.
Like, oh, you, like, Georgia? Yeah, me too. That's
but
so
the
weird.
I think the chance of them actually meeting up and actually finding out that about each other is still pretty.
That
would be really crazy.
Well, it's definitely small really world crazy. Shit.
I think it's vocational because doesn't she teach English over
there? No idea. I don't know.
I would imagine that that's how they met, is that a lot of people from America that have American English, or a lot of people from Britain that have British English as their first language, can go to a lot of other countries
with
a college education, no matter what their degree is in, and teach English because it's their first language.
We actually had a friend who did that. She went to, what was it? Was it Korea?
Yeah.
Yeah. Seoul is
Monique. She went and she was teaching English out there for a while.
Like Mo?
Mm-hmm. Mo.
I had no idea she did that. I knew she traveled like all the damn time, but
yeah, she left the country and taught English. I want to say it was for a little bit less than a year.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Got a BS history degree, got a degree in biochemistry and you know, Johnson & Johnson ain't hiring. Hey, go teach English in the Southeast Asia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. Actually, that's talk about culture.
That's how I got my Xbox 360.
By teaching English in Southeast Asia.
This guy that worked with my brother was moving to Korea to teach English, and he was like selling off all his shit because he was, you know, leaving the country. He didn't need it. And that's how I got my Xbox 360 with like 20 games for like $200.
That's awesome.
Yep. That's awesome. That's awesome. I just had a deputy that works at the courthouse. She was telling us how she went to Taiwan for 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. And in 3 weeks, she spent $300.
Dang.
For everything.
Just all on hookers?
Well, apparently they were available, readily available for anybody.
That's what I hear. Yeah.
That's what I hear.
Yeah.
See,
but
I've never left the country. I've always wanted to leave the country. I never have. And I think for my next vacation, I want to leave the country, but I have to get a passport.
Not only have you not left the country, I found out just earlier tonight, you've never been on a plane.
I've never been on a plane, no.
Not once.
Not once. Nope, not never once.
Not even just passing through it.
Nope.
This is what a plane's like. Okay.
Excuse me. Oh, yep. Looks like a big old.
All right, they're telling you to buckle your seatbelt, so that's my cue to get out of here, guys.
No. Hey,
have a great
night.
Lie.
It's a lie. You have been on a plane before. When we went to Ohio or Indiana, we went through that U.S. Air Force like museum or something.
Okay, so
there's picture proof.
You were on a decommissioned plane.
I was on a decommissioned plane inside a building that was a museum for the Air Force. Right.
Where usually half of it is cut off so you
Liar!
Can kind of look into it.
God, caught me red-handed. Yeah. No, but I've never flown. Yeah. The opportunity has come up a few times. I've been in airports, and it's really funny. Love airports.
Oh, yeah.
Every time I've been to an airport, I'm like, oh, this is so cool. Mm-hmm. There's so many different cultures just like stuffing themselves into this one giant building. But I've never actually gotten on a plane and taken off.
Somewhere.
No. Yeah. Yeah. But I do have a first flight coming up here really soon.
Yeah, you're right. Where are you going?
Going to Colorado for vacation.
Colorado.
Denver.
Woo!
I'm going to go with them as a bodyguard.
Yeah.
Yep. Make sure nobody messes with them. We've got a big following in the Denver area, and I don't want anybody.
I was going to say you're going to tell everybody in the Colorado area about Talkie Box, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. We're going to be heavily promoting in Colorado.
Do you have your bumper stickers ready? Do you have you got a ton of those printed?
We do need to get some merch put together.
Everywhere we go, people think that he's Fitz and or the Tantrums.
Are you one of the Tantrums?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Watch me clap in time.
Oh my gosh.
Now, Destiny, we got way off track, but you did not tell us a damn thing about yourself.
She's related to this guy.
Yeah. Except for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all you need to know.
I'm married. You married us.
I did perform.
You know that.
Yeah, I performed your wedding. Mm-hmm. Which I'm available for other weddings.
You did a great
job. Self-plug.
At very reasonable rates.
Yes.
Very reasonable.
Yeah, it was good stuff. I'm married. Next month is going to be 2 years already.
Yeah.
Already.
Let me know when you want to renew those vows. I'll do that.
Oh, yeah. You know it. I might do what Katie's sister did and go to Vegas and get one of the Elvis guys to do it for me. Make it a rule.
You can go fuck yourself right now.
You got to be a part of it the first time.
Hey, whatever he
authentic
charges you, I'll do it for $20 less.
Okay. So then you're going to pay me $20.
Oh, so there's an Elvis impersonator that's going to marry you in Vegas for nothing.
Yeah.
Well, then go. Don't let me slow you down.
I bet I can find one.
I'm not doing it for any less than me paying you $10.
So how old are you?
I'm going to be 26.
All right, we're going to tell everybody you're 18 because that's going to get those views way up there.
I'm sorry, excuse me. I'm 17 going on 18 in two weeks.
We need you to be legal.
I'm basically there. That's the same thing.
Yeah.
Basically.
And still married.
Still married.
For almost 2 years.
Yeah.
Watch out, guys.
And you didn't grow up in Georgia.
No. Yeah. I grew up in Tennessee, Indiana for a short detour for about 2 years.
Yep.
And then we moved here to Georgia in 2002. And I've been here since then, so I basically am from Georgia at this point.
Yeah, 15 years. That's
a long time.
That's a good amount.
That's most of your life.
Yeah. Yep.
Especially if you're only 17.
right? I've had a very long
brief
life
stint in Indiana for 2 years. Born in Tennessee, was there for about 4 days.
but I was raised
there. To Indiana for 2 years, came back to Georgia for 15. Here I am.
Yeah.
Has managed to fly on a plane.
Had
multiple times.
Wow.
Yes. We went to Jamaica for our honeymoon, so I've been out of the country.
And they didn't take you?
No.
Oh, man.
For their honeymoon, no, believe it or not. Yeah. I don't believe it. Along.
I mean, I'm pretty sure that brother-in-law is supposed to go on the honeymoon. Every romantic comedy I've ever seen, honeymooners at the beach.
Well, we weren't very traditional. We thought we would be a little different and just go by ourselves.
You've got to be the Danny McBride of the entire scenario. Or whatever.
Guys, listen, you stay away from my sister.
But we're married.
Hey. She's taken.
Danny McBride. He's a funny comedian.
He sure is.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Yeah. Good stuff.
He's been in some good things.
Oh, yeah.
He's bound and down. Have you seen that?
I've seen a few episodes of it. It's really good.
It's pretty good.
It's on HBO?
Mm. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm.
I need to catch up on that one.
Yep. We watched a few episodes. Yeah.
It's a funny show.
Yeah.
Yeah. I saw the first season or two. He does the apocalypse movie, right? With
This
where
is the
everybody
end.
Plays themselves.
Yeah, this is the end. That was a great one. Mm-hmm. That was a great movie.
That's a great version of him. I know everybody's just playing characterized versions of themselves in that movie, but still.
Brilliantly done.
Or 30 Minutes or Less. That's a great one. He acts a fool on that one.
Oh, I love that one.
It's really good.
He acts a fool in just about everything he
does. Well, yeah, but
probably Tropic Thunder is one of my favorite roles of his, but it's also possibly one of the best, like, comedic movies of all time.
It's a great comedic ensemble.
So the ensemble cast there, like, it
which
kind
is
of
weird
overshadows.
It's got two actors I'm not a big fan of, like Ben Stiller. I'm not a huge fan of, and Jay Baruchel. I don't really like that much, but it still makes for a really good movie. I typically like movies they do with kind of big ensemble things, but if Ben Stiller's the main star, I typically don't like it that much.
Yeah.
Well, with Tropic Thunder, I think one of my favorite pieces about it, and it's a shame because he'll never get the credit that he's due for it just because it was blackface, but Robert Downey Jr. Was brilliant. He was awesome, like, forwards and backwards. He was just great in that movie, and he will never get credit because it's such a controversial role.
It really is. Yeah.
What do you mean, you people?
It's so good.
But they make fun of that aspect.
They
it's
do.
Not like they ever take it seriously.
No, they don't
the
take it seriously.
But you still can't talk about it like that. You still can't give an award for that.
I remember when we went and saw this movie in the theater. It was me, Destiny, and my dad. And we all went to see this in the theater. And the very beginning of the movie starts off with, like, fake commercials and trailers. And the first one is Al Pacino's booty sweat commercial. And it's just like, just shaking asses and booty sweat advertisement. It's just, it just plays up this great big, like, rap video-esque commercial. Right. And it just catches you off guard. And I'm sitting there next to my dad. And as soon as it pops on, he's like, what the fuck? And like,
what are you watching?
Like, he just got so confused and so, like that confused, angry, like, hold on. Like, what is this?
This is not what I signed up for.
This is not what I wanted.
This is inappropriate with my
children.
This is
a Coca-Cola product. Ooh.
I'm going to write an angry email.
Yep.
No, but it was hilarious to see him.
Dear
just
polar
that, like,
bears.
That knee-jerk reaction to just shaking asses and booty sweat. And then once it kept going, then he kind of relaxed a little bit because he realized what was going on. Like, oh, okay, I see.
That reminds
if you
me
don't
of
understand by fatties.
Yeah, when you get to fatties, that's the cue that this is all bullshit.
Now, your dad's pretty cool, though. He'll take that stuff in stride. And
oh, yeah, absolutely.
I remember going to see, it was one of the Bond movies. I can't remember which one it was, but it was one that had Denise Richards.
Okay,
that's Christmas Jones.
Tomorrow Never Dies?
Was it Tomorrow Never Dies? Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
About Pipelines.
Yeah, that was Tomorrow Never Dies, because one with Halle Berry was Die Another Day.
Sure. Anyway, so I went and saw that. Now, I've said before on the show, like, I grew up in a very Christian household.
Goldeneye.
And I was actually pretty close to our preacher, who was like a younger guy. So we went and saw that movie together. And there's a line at the very end where James Bond is doing his thing, where he's hooking up with the Bond lady.
Of course.
And then he says the line, I thought Christmas only comes once a year. And I'm sitting there next to a preacher going, huh.
What does that mean?
I'm going to have to pretend like we never saw this movie.
Oh, that's excellent. Funny. That's excellent.
Well, I mean, Ian Fleming has actually written a good deal more sexy stuff into the actual Bond
in the books.
Okay. you know, all of the Bond girls in the old days, they used to have real sexist, like, obvious names.
Oh, yeah.
Like Pussy Galore?
Yeah, like yeah. Pussy Galore, you know, Putang Plenty. I don't know.
Can I just take you back for a second? I didn't realize they were 007 books.
Those oh, yeah.
Books?
Yeah, that's where they came from.
Yep.
Yeah,
that's Ian where the movies Fleming came from. Actually wrote spy mini novelettes or whatever, mm-hmm. I guess.
I thought it was just Sean Connery wanting to
wanting to flex out.
Yeah, and just have it go on forever.
All right, guys, so here's the plan for the next movie. I'm going to get tan. I'm going to keep my shirt off most of the time. Having sex with broads and shooting a gun with a silencer. Write the script.
How do you feel about the swamp, Sean?
Listen, I just hate Russians. Put that in there.
All right. Cubans? Can we put Cubans and Russians? In the swamp?
Yeah.
Thanks,
yeah.
Sean.
All right, perfect.
Script's done.
All right.
Sean, I remember you playing a Russian in that submarine movie.
Listen, I want there to be at least...
That's like 10 years from now.
Oh.
I want there to be at least two
guards.
You got
to say for Russians?
The Hunt for Red October was after the Bond career.
Yeah, I get that, but... The point is, he said he hates Russians.
He defected.
And the,
10 years later.
There should be two broads. One's good, one's bad. I fuck them both.
I'm glad you're back on track.
One in the middle, that's the bad one.
What was that accent?
Hey, it's my Irish. I don't have a Scottish accent very good.
Maybe you should not have your vibrating phone on the table.
Yeah,
unless you're a microphone that picks up every noise.
Unless you're the Talkie Box researcher, you should not have your phones out. That's just
I'm a newbie.
To our audience.
Phones
nobody
out.
Gave me dun, any kind of dun, rules.
Dun, dun.
So did anybody watch 13 Reasons Why on Netflix yet?
I didn't.
No, I have no idea what
no.
that is.
It was advertised to me. Yeah. I was in its demographic.
Netflix wanted you to watch it.
It did.
Netflix
it said,
wants you to watch everything that's made by Netflix.
We think at Netflix you might enjoy this. I don't know why they sound like Jar Jar Binks at Netflix.
From Germany?
Yes. A German.
Oh, Jesse, you're really liking this one.
Jar Jar Binks.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I don't know why they sound like that. But yeah, it's about like this girl that kills herself and she makes 13 mixtapes and sends them out to the 13 people at high school that... made her kill herself.
Yeah, but they're not mixtapes. They're like, she's sitting there talking.
This is like the song that I think about.
John Cusack, like, holding the boom box over his head.
This mixtape's for you.
It's just tons of pure songs.
I killed myself because I do. You were so mean in gym class.
Just a whole bunch of The Cure and Morrison just all over the place.
I like The Cure.
I like The Cure, too.
I do, too.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, we agree.
Yeah, there we go.
Perfect. Are they in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
I don't know.
I have no idea.
I've looked that up.
Oh, man.
You know, you have an iPad right there.
I do.
Look that up. Meanwhile, talk about something else. Anyway, 13 Reasons Why. You saw it?
Yeah, I did.
Was it good?
Yeah, I read the books, or read the book first a few years ago.
I didn't know
ago.
It came in a book. Did it?
Shut up.
I didn't actually know it came in a book for
it. No, yeah, it was a book, and it's 10 years old now, and it's... It's really good. It makes you really want to keep reading, and the show is just the same, but the show is it's graphic. The different scenes that they have, they make it very raw and very graphic, so it doesn't romanticize is the word they were looking for.
It doesn't romanticize
like
the suicide? And,
yeah, it doesn't make it seem like it's all... You know.
Like you should do that.
Yeah. Right,
they're
right, right.
Like us on Facebook. Suicide. Trending today.
The Cure is not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Bastards.
Oh, well.
They should be.
Snubbed.
Next year.
Snubbed.
Next year.
Maybe.
Yeah, there's still forever to put them in the Hall of Fame. They don't have to. Yeah. There's not a statute of limitations on that.
Like,
honestly, it probably hasn't been long enough for them to be in it.
Right. Probably not.
Was it 25 years?
Yes.
25 years? Yeah, I don't think it's been long enough.
Because Pearl Jam had they had just qualified this last year.
Well, then it must have been long enough then, because Cure was in the 80s. Cure started in the 80s. So snubbed.
Yep.
Snubbed.
Bunch of dicks that rock and
roll.
Well,
when does the 25 years start? Is it 1 year
from their
first album release?
Oh, well then, what's the holdup?
Right. All
right.
Write your congressman.
Yeah. Tell him we need a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in this state.
Yeah.
Whatever state you happen to be in.
Yeah.
If it's Ohio, you're winning.
Yeah, you've got a lead on everybody. I did see somebody else write about Tupac being brought into the. So we were on the cutting edge of that news story.
We are constantly on the cutting edge.
Other people were following in our wake. Like, what's up with Tupac? Like, that's so yesterday.
That's so episode one, guys.
Yeah, we talked about that long time.
Yep.
Love you long time.
And we do. We love you.
We really do.
For a long time, we have.
Yeah. We think about you constantly.
All the time.
Mm-hmm. See, you know who you are.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So what are you besides 13 Things I Hate About You,
what are you into?
What are you into? What do you listen to? You like music?
I love music.
All right, good story. Dave, what about you?
Yeah. I also like when she listens to music.
Yeah. You like the fact that she likes music?
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Me too.
Yeah, if you don't like music, you're weird.
So that's true. Like what you like the T-Swift, right?
Yeah, I love T-Swift.
Oh, Tay Tay.
I love Tay Tay. I heard that she's coming out with an album in December. So if y'all need any ideas for Christmas gifts,
how many guys do you think she slept with since the last time that she had an album come out?
There's no telling. But apparently, I did just hear on the radio. I don't know how true it is, but I heard that her house is going to be a national landmark.
What?
Which is just ridiculous.
Why? Like the house she lives in now, or like the one she grew up in, or.
I don't know.
I need you to have more detail on this story.
It was a quick
it's
little.
It's important.
It was like on the radio in between.
More
song,
celebrity
you know?
Sex has happened at this house than any other house in recorded national history.
I was wondering if they were on the same note or if we had just switched to a different thing. Like is the house going to be a historical landmark because she sleeps around a lot? I don't understand.
Yeah.
I didn't think she slept around that much. Does she?
I mean, she.
She had a lot of boyfriends, so they automatically assumed that she. She likes to sleep around.
But it's probably just for promotional reasons, right?
Like, or it could be that she was a young 20-something just living her life dating people. Because who doesn't date multiple people?
I mean, yeah, what's up with the double standard, Jason?
Were they all normies or were they famous people?
They were virtually all famous people.
Yeah,
right.
Mostly.
So and promotional dating some, is yeah. completely some. An okay thing.
Famous people are pretty. Pretty people want to sleep
with
pretty
looking,
people.
Hey, you're good looking. Our agents are sleeping together. Why don't we form a relationship? On TV camera and then
make
can,
a lot of money
mm-hmm.
and then we
and then,
can get
and then write popular. Songs about each other when we break up
yeah and then we
exactly
can write yeah I've had this song about breaking up that I can't get published for like 6 years but if I break up with you
they're gonna all assume it's about
they're
you
they're gonna love the shit out of it
yeah. Destiny who's your favorite artist all right let's everybody talk shit about him for 15 minutes
yeah but I also like guy singers too it's not just ladies that I like the 1975 and I like Bastille.
Yeah. Both good bands. Really, I'm a big fan.
Has Bastille put out anything recently?
Yeah, they had an album come out
November,
few
October,
ago,
September.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow, all right,
something
well,
like that.
Like 6 years. Do you know the
great.
Exact date? Because you seem to be up on this.
I don't know the exact date anymore.
Well,
she did it one time.
I did know it at one time. I was counting down for it. Yeah. I'd been waiting for like 2 years.
I like Bastille though. They have some really good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
There was this, the cover they did of Rhythm of the Night.
Oh, oh my
fantastic.
God! I love that song.
Just the rhythm.
I yep. love that song. That's we rocked out sing. To that at Music Midtown yeah. when they came in 2014.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I've never been. Amazing. Never been to Music Midtown.
Really?
Nope. Well, didn't go to the original. Time. Didn't go. I haven't been to the revamp.
It's a blast. It's a You'll time. Get tons of exercise.
Yeah.
I've heard.
I don't like the feeling of being squished in by on all sides.
Well, you're not people. Really. It's all about how you choose. I mean, you can choose to get real close up in action, or you can just kind of hang back and be like at a picnic. You can yep. still see the show, but you're. You know, you're comfortable. You're not crammed
in. I've saw some photos of a real wet Music Midtown where, like, people were just all kind of smushed into big muddy areas.
Yeah.
And
yeah, that happens.
Everybody looked kind of miserable. And
it's so called now, living life.
Now every time I think about Music Midtown, I
think
just
of like a big wet
you think
sloppy
that
mess.
About
yeah.
a big wet sloppy mess.
Well, last year it was breath. A really sloppy mess, and it was really miserable at the time. But then it ends up being good stories later.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
when my Converse were disgusting because they were absolutely covered in mud.
When I lost
water.
My wallet and a Good Samaritan.
Yeah, that was ridiculous. That's just not even real life. You got way lucky with that. Some,
really,
you lose
really.
Everything that you have that's valuable and some dude drives from Atlanta to Lawrenceville and has everything intact waiting for you.
That's
that
fantastic.
Doesn't happen to anybody.
Oh, it was wild. I was distraught. It was the last day. We had all like gotten a hotel.
Yeah.
And it was super rainy.
And it was super rainy and nasty. And at one point they like halted the shows. So we left the park And then there was this big debate about whether or not they were going to open the show back up, like what was going to happen. And it was the last day. Mm-hmm. So I'm walking around and we get separated from our group. Eventually we like get back in track and a hold of everybody. None of the cell phone service is working. And then we're like, all right, well, they're opening back up the show. I'm going to go buy a beer. I go to buy a beer. My wallet's not in my pocket.
Uh-oh.
I search
or the hotel room key or his license or any cash.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So I'm like searching up and down everywhere that I've walked. I can't find it anywhere. And I realized that we have since left the park and come back into the park with like hundreds of people, thousands of people going
stampeding
in and out.
Through inches thick of mud.
And I'm like, I'm never going to find this thing. And probably like 2-3 days later, I got a Facebook message from some random person saying, hey, how's it going? We found your wallet on the ground.
Yeah.
We have all of it. We live in the area, so we're going to bring it by.
Damn.
And they drove by and just gave me all of my cash, all of my everything. And I tried to give them some money. Just like, oh, my God, thank you so much.
Yeah, I was going to ask.
Don't worry about it.
No, he was kind of douchey about it because he was in his suit and his nice car, and he's like, I don't need it. Thanks, though. It's just like, okay, I mean, you were nice.
That's
nice.
You know, I'm sorry. A little bit. Still super nice guy. Super nice guy. Don't listen to her.
I looked at your credit cards, and I felt so bad for you. I could not keep this wallet.
I can't take that money.
I was like, I've been making large. I steal American Express black cards. And you got like a Chase Bank blue.
Yeah. You need this more than I do.
I'm going to get back in my... nice ride.
I don't know how it happened, but I got being weird. Super
mine?
Lucky.
Mine? No, is it my voice?
Here, everybody guard your ears for a sec.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I wish I hadn't done that.
Uh-oh. Because you didn't guard your ears.
Did we fix it? Am I fixed?
Yeah, you are fixed.
You're fixed.
All right, good.
I think you were coming in on Destiny's mic for quite a while.
It happens.
You have a voicemail from Michael. That's real weird.
Hmm. Yeah. Well,
you let him know you're on a show.
Yeah. Tell him.
I was freaked out.
Hey, bae. Live broadcasting. No, we're not.
It's pre-recorded.
If you check it, you should be able to read what it says.
The voicemail?
Yeah, just not that microphone around.
Hey,
yeah.
You know what?
But just so you know,
it'll transcribe the voicemail for
Dave
you.
Dave is not going to edit any of this out.
Not a bit of it.
Especially
that's cool.
If we talk about
and you can just
out.
See what I'm doing, that's all.
If you can point that at the camera so we can know what he said.
Go to the voicemail. Go to the actual voicemail. In the bottom right, yeah.
Today, Talkie Box learns how to use voicemail
he
on iPhones.
No?
No, it's fine.
That's weird.
I'll get it. I'll listen to it in a little bit.
Yeah.
Just freaks me out a little bit. He didn't never leave me voicemails.
Weird. Oh. Weird.
It's like he loves you or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Good for him.
Yeah. Yeah. Good for me.
Also you.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, it's good for me.
It's good for everybody.
So we're going to Colorado.
You're going to Colorado.
And, aside from going on a hike, mm-hmm. I have no idea what else we're going to do.
I want to ski, but apparently I am the only one.
Well, it might be too late. Is there still going to be snow?
Is skiing an option this late into the season?
From my understanding, the Rocky Mountains are vast and tall.
Right.
And that there are ski resorts year-round in them.
I mean, they also are not all in Colorado.
That's true.
Yeah.
But a good portion of them are.
We are going to be in Denver. That I think like Brad's apartment is actually in downtown Denver, or at least close to it. Like he's there.
Yeah.
He is there. So it's gonna be a nice little getaway. We're gonna do like 5 days, I think. Mm-hmm. And gonna try and find some fun things to do.
I'm sure there's plenty to do.
I'm sure you're going to find plenty to do in Denver, Colorado.
Nicolas Cage was in that movie, right? Things to do in Denver when you're dead?
Probably.
And we're going to be alive.
Yeah.
His full mic's acting funny again.
Is my mic dropping out again?
No, I'm hearing a little static from
it's
it.
It's a
I don't
little staticky.
About.
Why are you breaking it?
I don't hear myself in my headphones, so I have no idea what y'all are going through.
Yeah, it looks like you're...
on the spot maintenance.
On the spot maintenance. If only we had somebody to work the board.
But yeah, but, you know, really we just need EQ that's not, you know, white label. We need some of that superior equipment.
Superior equipment. Superior quality.
Yeah.
Superior sound.
Yeah.
Yeah. THX. That would help.
We need to make money. off of this enterprise so that we can
make money,
become bigger and better and more entertaining.
All right, so we're going to have to get some stickers made up.
Right.
Oh, yeah, yep. Definitely bumper stickers. You should get them of the little talkie bot, and you can pass them out in Colorado.
Let's
and
make
stick
some coffee mugs
car.
And some pens.
Mm-hmm. I want a bobblehead.
Bobblehead. If you can make the mold for the bobblehead.
No, I want a bobblehead. It has nothing to do with talkie box.
Just like a Jason
Martin. It doesn't matter. He just wants a bobblehead.
Yeah. Like
he does not care.
Like a robotic sort of attachment to my spine. So that I can just sort of just bobblehead out whenever.
I mean, you can do that whenever you want anyways.
Yeah, but I want it to look like
it should be doing.
Well, if you wait like another maybe 50 years, it could come naturally for you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, they're already talking about all kinds of these like human enhancements that people are working on.
Are you going to be a cyborg?
You know, if the opportunity presents itself.
Ta-da.
And the technology is sound.
Opportunity.
I will get an eye implant. I'll get a memory chip in my brain.
Will you? Eyeball implant.
Yeah, you better.
You're afraid of flying.
I will get an eyeball implant.
All right.
Because I feel like the risk of me falling to my death from hundreds and thousands of feet is much more reduced from an eye implant than from flying in a plane.
Yeah. The risk of brain aneurysm or eyeball implant infection deaths are much higher on an eyeball implant than from flying.
You don't know that. Maybe the pressure, something with the
I
pressure.
I actually do know that.
What percentage would you give it?
100.
100%.
Wow, that's a high percentage.
Yeah, it seems like
that's pretty
I have
much
a high
the most
risk
that you can get, I think.
Yeah.
High risk for the eye implant. No, you know, we've talked about AR and augmented reality and virtual reality and stuff, and I think that there could be utility, and I believe that you give it 25 years, it'll be a common thing.
I mean,
thing.
I am down AF as fuck about goggles. All right? Goggles, give me goggles all day. Give me some interactive goggles.
You don't want like a contact lens?
I could deal with a contact lens possibly, but actual robot eye, like, now you're starting to freak me out a little bit.
Is it only because you're replacing your own eye with another eye?
Yes.
Because, I mean, they do, like, cochlear implants and stuff. That people are putting stuff in their heads already.
As long
and
as
have
I'm
been
not
for
the
years,
guinea.
Mm-hmm. And decades.
As long as I'm not the guinea pig.
Right.
Well, right. I mean, it would be tested. Perfected. It would be tested. I'm not going to be like, oh, you got eye implants? Pick me.
I don't want
to
be.
No, I want to wait for it to be a commercially offered thing, like, come get your eye implant today.
I just get
a memory chip thrown in free of charge.
It seems to me that they've done eye transplants before.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So just switching your eye with something else that's also going to connect in the exact same way, probably not that big a deal.
What if it gave you like super, super HD
vision? That's what we're hoping for.
Right. Like maybe some analytics, like you can look and something's moving, it'll let you know how fast it's moving and what its trajectory is. It can do like predictive paths and stuff like that.
I feel like we're talking about assassins right now, like
yeah.
Sharpshooters.
But now it's not just an eye, because you're going to have like implants in your brain to interpret all of that data.
Well, that's already like going to be much. That's going to have to be a thing anyway. Like otherwise, having a cybernetic eye isn't going to do you any good.
No, it's going to be extra weight.
Yeah.
when you're drowning.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh, I'm sinking. Oh, thank God. You shouldn't have made it out of gold.
Heavy shit, man.
Right.
No, but if you don't have gold, it's not nearly gaudy enough.
Or conductive.
That would be one of those status symbols. Like, how's it going?
Bling.
Why'd you just cover your eye when you
No, I would wink and leave the cybernetic eye open.
Gotcha. Okay, right. That makes sense.
Draw more.
Would you change the color if you could?
I would probably have a red glow behind the, or maybe a blue glow. Yeah.
I mean, I would think you would get to change whatever you want about it.
Right.
Like, today I'll go with blue.
Yep. Siri,
I want like electric blue today, please.
I'd like neon purple. Thank you.
I'd like a strobe effect on.
I want rainbow today, please.
Heck
that
yeah.
That would just freak people out.
Now, now you...
interesting.
You talked about, or you mentioned that he has a fear of falling, and that's something I want to talk about. Do you have other fears besides just heights?
I mean, like, nothing that's crippling or debilitating, but, you know, just like most people, there are things that you have, everybody has mild and differing degrees of phobias.
Yeah.
So claustrophobia, I'm not going to, like, cry and piss and shit my pants and have a complete mental breakdown if I'm stuck in a closet, but I'm sure as shit not going to like it.
Right.
Yeah.
So like, now, I am going to cry and piss and shit my pants when I get on the plane. I've already come to peace with it.
You want to bring some extra pants?
No, yeah, I mean, pants. I've got the Depends already packed. Like, yeah. It's going to be a good thing. But, I mean, and it's really funny because it really is almost exclusive to planes and driving on mountain roads.
Okay.
Like, when we used to go to Gatlinburg when we were kids, and nothing gave me more anxiety than driving up the mountain because you're so close to the edge on these roads that...
Just a hot chew and...
You know, there
well,
you go.
Let me give you a tip. Don't ever go to Jamaica and ride in those vehicles going up the
mountain. Oh, no, you already told me stories.
It's scary. Yeah? We kind of thought we might be dying on our honeymoon, for real. It was really scary.
Damn.
Yeah, like, that's not okay. I used to be terrified of roller coasters, but I've gotten over that. Like, I don't mind roller coasters now. I don't like the ascent.
I had the same thing. I was scared of roller coasters, and then I went on one, and I was like, this is amazing. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I was ever scared of this.
I like roller coasters. I hate the ascent. Even though I'm strapped in, just like that, tick, 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 I feel like I'm just going to fall over the back of the seat and just whack my head a few times on the tracks.
Or did you see that video of that guy on the, I think it's the fastest... roller coaster in Indiana, and as he's going super fast, like 80 miles an hour, bird whacks him in the face.
That happened to Fabio.
For real?
Fabio? Yeah, Fabio.
The model slash book cover model actor.
Yeah, he was on a roller coaster and got hit in the face with a seagull or something like that.
Oh my gosh.
Bloodied him up pretty bad.
That's a big bird. The bird for that guy was probably killed, and it probably messed up his face.
Oh no, like you couldn't tell if the blood on his face was from the bird or if it was from him, but he still was like a champ. After he got the bird off of him, he still put his hand up and enjoyed the rest of the ride. Even though I feel like his face had to
a feather like dangling out of his mouth.
Well, it hit his face, and then it kind of like got stuck here on his neck because it was going. I mean, it was going so
really fast.
Yeah.
Like hugging his neck, like.
And then he hit it like he was like, "What the?"
Punched in the head by a bird.
I've often wondered, like, how many people are getting hit in the face with bugs and stuff while they're on...
The dude sitting next to him had his mouth wide open. I'm just like, oh! Like,
see, like, for a roller coaster, I've gone on enough that it's not that bad. Yeah. It's a thrill ride. It's relatively short-lived. With a plane, I'm putting my life into the hand of this giant flying machine that is in no way rooted on ground.
We've been in a crazy Uber before.
Completely based on magic principles. To remember that...
Yep.
There's no science guiding those those giant tubs in
absolutely.
The air. That is Merlin.
Absolutely, yep. Damn you,
it's
Merlin.
It's just magic that no one understands.
Well, lift, thrust, okay, got it.
Yeah, black magic and leprechauns, that's all it is up there.
Listen, before I get on this plane, I just need to meet Dumbledore.
Yep. Is this like Bumblebees, how it shouldn't work, but it works?
Yep.
I got it, no problem.
Cool.
You want me to pay you money, take this ride? No car.
All right.
Yeah. Des, you got fears?
I mean, kind of the same thing. Like, I don't, claustrophobia. I don't care about sitting in a closet or anything, but if I'm going to like a cave or something where there's not really an exit and it's a small opening, I don't like that.
Just
I don't
fear of being trapped.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. I really don't like,
I probably
like
will never go spelunking.
Has anybody ever gone spelunking? Cause that's
what
a deep
that?
Darkness.
I've like, never, not really. I mean, I've been in caves that like on tours of like,
right.
Mammoth
gold
caves.
Mammoth, yeah.
Like,
where they turn off the lights and you get to experience total darkness.
Gosh, so
and
scary.
It's like, for me, it was awesome.
I mean, it was so crazy cause you put your hand in front of your face and like, I don't see this.
Nope.
I don't,
you don't see,
I don't
your
see
hand
this.
At all.
Like,
but then like somebody lights
everybody's wallet right now.
Somebody lights up like a Bic lighter in like a 400 square foot room and it's like perfect clarity.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I can see everything with this one
tiny there's the
flame.
Quarter I dropped.
Yeah.
It's really
there's
funny
the
how
I
like
dropped.
Light is relative and how quickly your eyes adjust.
Yeah.
But spelunking where you like you have cables and you have a flashlight and some shit on your helmet and then you are just like crawling through cracks in the earth as deep as you can go. Aw, nah, hell nah, man.
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely.
I did it with the Boy Scouts. We went with a group and parents tried to accompany us. And I say try.
Because they were too big, weren't they?
Because they were too big and too out of shape to follow the course. There were many parents had to turn around and go back at different points. The Fat Man Squeeze, obviously, if they name a place, Fat Man Squeeze, and you're looking at yourself and you're like, I'm a fat man. What's going to happen here? Well, you're going to get squoze. That's what it's called. So we lost a couple there. There was one where it was...
You say you lost a couple.
We lost a couple on that one. Yeah, they never got back.
They got trapped. We literally had to crawl over them.
Four orphans on this trip. Four orphans were made on this trip.
We just took one of our chisels and a hammer, put them out of their misery, and kept moving.
One place called Bubblegum Alley, which was just like that Georgia red clay, so thick that it was like knee deep. And like they told the guides, like, hey, take your shoes off, carry them with you. And, you know, the kids that were paying attention to the guides did that and kept their shoes. The parents all lost their shoes.
Yeah.
Because they all, you know, they were parents and they knew what they were doing. Like, this was for the kids. We don't need to listen. You know, we're making jokes and stuff.
Oh, my shoe.
And those shoes, it creates a vacuum once you step down in there. And it takes shoes, socks, and they're gone.
You know, it's trying to take your pants, too.
It would. It would take everything. Like, as you're walking through
that. I remember in Boy Scouts, you got that belt cinched up tight.
There was one that was like a tunnel that was after that that was should have been called Fat Man Squeeze because it was actually a tighter space than Fat Man Squeeze, and you had to crawl through it.
Well, they assumed that they had already weeded out all the fat men before.
No. Yeah. I will not crawl and through a tunnel
and
in the earth.
We lost a mom on that one. She actually got halfway through and lost her shit. Just started to feel like, I'm not having any luck, and I'm starting to feel...
I'm stuck,
and so I was already through by this time.
Yeah.
Oh, and they made us wait until they yanked her back out the other side.
Oh my gosh.
That would be nerve-wracking, though. Imagine, like, being on your stomach, like, completely surrounded by rock and being told, keep
crawling.
Can't
see back, can't see forward, really?
Yeah, it's just pitch, and you're just...
Just punching microphones.
Yep, punching microphones left and right.
Get in it.
After a while... If you are not feeling yourself make sufficient progress, the feel of
I'm going to die down here.
It creeps up real quick, I would imagine. I would probably be feeling the same way.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to die
down here.
I might as well lose my fucking mind in the meantime.
If I was that woman by myself,
Why are you there?
Well, that, all
that's
but
terrifying.
Like, that would be, I could see that getting really, really freaky and terrifying. But like, if I know
suddenly
that
there's
I'm
a monster chasing you
and there's like people on both sides
there's
of
human
me
beings on both
who
sides
who can help me out, I wouldn't be all that weird about it. It wouldn't bother me.
No, she lost
I
her
think
shit.
It depends. I think it depends on the situation. Like, I think about having like an MRI and that freaks me out. Like being in a tube, having to be completely still, like not being able to
back up a little bit. There you go.
Look around at all. Perfect. Like that. Sorry.
No,
it's fine.
You were over-talking the mic.
Well, because this thing keeps moving.
I know.
Yeah,
it's
awesome.
You're not used to the microphone. I get it. It's fine. I'm not mad at you. I was just letting you know.
Thanks.
Continue with your MRI story.
I don't want to do it. Yeah. Okay. I don't want to be in one.
I kind of feel the same way, and it's actually for this weird reason that I think, like, what if at some point I just got, like, a BB or a sliver of metal or something, like,
and it gets yanked out of your body,
just pushed into some kind of little place, some little nook or cranny, and I get into an MRI that's like basically a super magnet, right?
Yep, and it just rips your body,
and it just yanks a BB through my eye hole. That happened to just be like, oh, I thought that was a cyst this whole time, like, oh no, that was.
Hopefully, they'd be able to tell the difference between a cyst and a BB.
I mean. Maybe I can't, though.
Yeah. You know? The MRI doesn't care.
Well, wouldn't they do like an x-ray before they put you in an
MRI? I don't know. Never had an MRI.
Do they do skull x-rays?
They can.
Oh, well, then I guess they should, right? Just in case you got metal in your skull.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to put some radiation in there just make sure that you don't have metal
in there.
Just
to make sure there's no
BBs. Yeah.
This is to be a clean process. One time a guy got in here, BB shot through his eye hole.
Oh, my God.
So, broke the machine, too.
Broke the machine, killed the guy. I mean, broke the machine. The guy's all right.
He's fine.
He's got a new cyborg eye. It's cool.
It's real cool, man.
Yeah, you can see thermal imaging. He can actually MRI you while you stand in front of him.
Yeah, I don't know why we don't use him.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, we got this machine.
Anyway, get in that tube.
go on and get in that death tunnel.
Yeah. It's going to make some real loud noises. It's going to be great, though. You're going to love it.
Wear this weird, funny helmet. Here, take that.
Well, Jason, any fears? You big fist?
I don't have fears. Like, I generally, when I feel anxious or start to feel fear come on, it actually frustrates me and makes me sort of angry.
Yep.
And mm-hmm. so I generally attack that which I am afraid of.
Right.
And in doing so, often conquer said fears.
Yeah.
I do have irrational issues with spider webs on my face.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that's irrational.
Also, little people. He has a thing about little people.
Yeah, I kind of have a thing about little people. That's true. Good catch.
Small hands and smell like cabbage.
It's mainly because one of the first and foremost of the little people I have met was a very unhygienic type of human being. And that just pushed my issue to an exacerbated level.
Is this
level.
The person you told me about?
Yes.
Yeah, yes. We can talk about it. Yeah. Spider webs in the face. We can talk about it.
Well, because then a spider web in the face, there's a chance that there could be a spider somewhere.
On your face.
On you, mm-hmm. crawling around up in your clothes. And
I don't like touching spider webs at all. If I touch a spider web, then all that's...
That actually stems from being a young child and being lost in the woods. Around like dusk when you're just losing the light and you're starting to get confused, and I was just wandering like looking for my home in the woods,
yeah.
and every fucking pair of trees that I walk through had a spider web. Like I would walk 2 feet, spider web would wrap itself fully around my face. I would freak out because I was lost and scared and beat the spider web off my face,
right.
and be like, okay, I think I know where it is. Walk 2 feet and a spider web would wrap around my face. And after like the 10th or 12th time, like I was that lady in that tube. I was freaking out, like now, 7 years old.
Is that when you started setting fires to everything?
That is around the age I started to set fires to everything. Like,
now, I've been assured that Jason did not burn down the interstate. He was sure to like make sure.
He put it on Facebook as a status.
I-85 is not me. I didn't do that. That's someone. That's another guy's.
I think you protest too much.
That's another guy's area.
Yeah,
they're arsonists are like gangsters. You can't. There's certain lines.
Don't encroach on territories.
Yeah.
But
for those of you
who
don't
phrase...
know, there's a section of I-85 in Atlanta that burned fucking down,
like literally burned down,
caught fire, fucking collapsed. Yeah. In not that long of a amount of time, it was just like an hour or two.
No,
right?
Yeah, it was.
Like,
I think it was within an hour.
Yeah.
And who did they blame? Crackheads.
Crackheads. Homeless crackheads.
Homeless crackheads.
I'm not even going to mention the fact that stuff shouldn't be stored underneath a highway anyways. But
And now they're saying like a long time before they gets replaced because they have to inspect the entire highway, or at least a very large section of the highway, to make sure that other parts of it aren't going to catch fire and collapse.
Odds are it was vengeful crackheads. But...
It shouldn't have had an opportunity to do so because they told him to leave.
They told him to get out of there, quit squatting under our bridge.
Yeah.
And they were like, all right, we'll quit squatting under this bridge because it's on fire. Mm-hmm.
This bridge is on fire.
But however, the conspiracy theorist in me, it says, follow the money.
Right.
MARTA burnt that shit down.
Oh, my God. No, but there is like... theories that this was done by like the federal government, like they did it on purpose.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
for those
everything.
Who don't
like
live
that.
In the Atlanta area, MARTA is the Metro Atlanta Rapid Transit System, Rapid Transit Authority. There we go.
Authority, as you say, that's MARTS.
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 Yeah. MARTA is SMARTA.
SMARTA, and they're making big dollars.
Dollar bills.
Dollar
time
bills.
For people running their trains and stuff.
But they only give out dollar coins.
But
which is a little bit of a pain in the ass.
Do they still do the coins? I thought
no, it's a card.
The
cards
now.
It's the MARTA card, yeah.
Oh, so they don't dispense coinage anymore?
Mm-mm. No, because you just use your... But you still...
Your MARTA card.
You have to pay for it before you can...
Yeah, you got
to
charge it up.
Get it on.
So you can't get tokens at the MARTA stops
I guess not.
Stops anymore?
I don't know. They did it... I haven't ridden MARTA since, like,
no, I'm just saying, if you load...
Or something.
If you load one of those cards, you can load it with cash.
Yeah.
But if you only want to put $10 in there and you slip a 20 in there, it's going to give you 10 gold dollar coins
back.
Oh,
that's true. That's not like MARTA coins. That's just dollar coins.
Yeah, I said dollar coins.
Like the Saskatchewans.
Oh, well. We assume. Or
the Sacagaweas.
Sacagaweas, yes.
Saskatchewan is not American currency. That's Canadian.
Saskatchewans.
Yeah. We've been on MARTA recently, so I mean, yeah, they don't really have the coins unless you just bring big bills.
When I worked inside the perimeter of Atlanta, those coins were everywhere. Like,
really?
Oh, yeah. I got tons of those in my restaurant all the time, just tons of those dollar coins.
But mass transit in Atlanta has always been kind of kind of defunct, kind of worthless. Like, love driving in Atlanta.
We do, but like,
I've got our interstates, and now all of a sudden people are like, oh, let's try mass transit.
When I went to school for one semester at Georgia State, I had to ride MARTA into Atlanta from just outside of, like, Kensington or something. And, like, that train filled up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, luckily I got on early enough that I could get a seat. But, like, if I got in, like, just two stations later, it was standing room only. Mm-hmm. So, like, MARTA gets used.
Especially for concerts and stuff.
It could be worse, though. I mean, you know, in Japan, that there are actually subway stuffers.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that is a job.
Shove them on in.
They just push people in so the doors will close, which is why anytime you see anything in Japan, like any sort of, like, movie or anime or whatever, mm-hmm. when they're in the subway, it is just packed on, people holding on to things. And
that's the thing about Japan, though. Like, it's not a big country with a whole shit ton of people in it.
Yeah. Yeah. So. But we need something. We could have MARTA more out towards the suburbs so a small folk can get to Atlanta without having to drive.
The issue with that is how many buildings we've expanded around the perimeter of Atlanta, though. Like, mm-hmm. putting those tracks somewhere, you got to take some stuff out.
Yeah.
At mm-hmm. this point, so.
Yeah.
And at this
dig.
Point.
Dig.
At this point, exactly. Mm-hmm. Like, we've talked in previous episodes about the future of automobile technology mm-hmm. and the future of self-transportation and stuff like that. So I feel like for them to try and invest in mass public transportation at this juncture is sort of a dollar, you know, too much, dollar too short, when cars are going to be driving. Yeah. You get what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That the cars are going to be driving themselves in 15 years. Yeah. So why put on this 15-year MARTA train plan when 15 years from now, when they finish that, no one will be on it. It'll be vacant because.
No, yeah. They should just convert that into, like, underground autonomous roads.
Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. I could mm-hmm. do that. Or above ground, you know, if mining is more expensive than going up.
Right. I figure the more space you have up top, the better. Then again, I've always been a big fan of the solar roadways. Solar roadways.
Is that why you said it twice?
Yeah.
Got it. So this makes me wonder about New York. Are they... So in New York City, they've got subways all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
Are they building more, or are they full up on subways?
Mm. I think they still extend them.
It's probably a never-ending project.
They may go farther out, but are they putting any more?
I don't think so. Probably not. I mean, that would probably be.
I think the infrastructure in, like, lower, like, subterranean Manhattan and New York City is probably all used up real estate. I would imagine.
Well, they're still building tunnels in England, like, and you figure, you know, England, they had aqueducts and stuff there. Like, that's an old country. You know, they've probably used up a great deal of their underground space in like guarding the chalice, the Holy Grail and stuff like that, you know, like. All the different.
You got to be careful with that Holy Grail, man. You never know who's going to come for it.
Right? All the Knights Templar. They've all got stashes and crazy graves and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Really cool shields.
Yeah.
So I don't know what they had to do with all that, but they're still building tunnels in England. So if they're doing that, they've got to still
Are the Knights Templar building the tunnels?
Yes.
Okay.
It's like the Tennessee Valley Authority over there. Thank you for laughing at that.
Yeah, I don't think that applies, but no, I'll give it to you.
All right, why not?
I didn't laugh.
No, because you didn't get it. Army Corps Engineers. But so how long we got? I can't see the thing. That's how I
Go about 6 minutes.
About 6 minutes?
Roughly.
That's not
roughly.
Too bad.
No, it's not.
We've had some conversations.
Snakes.
Snakes.
Yeah,
fair enough.
That's about the only thing. I don't really have a problem with heights. I don't have a problem with enclosed spaces. But snakes freak me out.
You would have had a hard time.
Like a little girl when you see snakes?
Like I've held snakes before and been fine. It's just like coming across them in the wild.
Mm. What about if you came across one in your bedroom when you got home?
Also that.
What about snakes on a plane?
That's more a question for you, isn't it?
Yeah, I wouldn't be a big fan. No, but I came home a few weeks back, and like I'd opened my bedroom door, and I was talking to somebody, I don't remember who it was, and I saw this little thing like underneath my door. I'm like, that's weird. Like, it looks like a string, or oh no, is that a rat tail? Oh God, is there a rat? So I opened the door and I look back, and it's a snake, about this long, just chilling out in my room. Luckily, he really liked the big red bucket that I surrounded him in, because he jumped right in.
Oh.
And then we released him into the wild.
With his little snake legs. Mm-hmm. Just hopped right in.
Yep. Hopped on it.
Released him into the wild and then hunted him down with a BB gun.
Yep.
Did you really?
The most dangerous game.
Tiny baby snakes. Yep.
All right. You have a 5-minute head start, baby snake.
But yeah, I've always been weird about snakes. I've tried to conquer my fears and like... I grew up down in South Georgia where there's swamps and there's snakes everywhere.
Everywhere.
And so like you go to these different field trips at places like the Okefenokee Swamp and stuff like that, and they introduce you to snakes.
Come
like,
to the Rattler Ranch.
Come taste it. I think there is one.
I name a lot of things.
Yeah. But you can go, you know, they have these giant snakes. You go up and pet them and stuff like that. And it's weird because they feel weird.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I don't mind them if they're behind glass. I don't mind them if I know where they are. It's when I come across one unexpectedly when I kind of flip out a little bit.
Yeah,
I've never like been like, oh, but I will like just immediately just back up.
Yeah,
hope, oh.
Yeah. That's how I feel about like bugs in general and snakes. I mean, yeah. I've like come across a handful of snakes in my life where I'm like in the wild.
Yeah,
and they startle me.
I don't fear things that I know fear me more. So
that's weird.
But you
because
hear
you
stories
should.
About them attacking
you should.
People.
I don't.
Because like fear is a very dangerous thing.
Yep.
That's how
like, people get bit.
Yep. That's also
they are
how like
afraid of you, and they want you gone.
Yeah.
That's also how animals die. Like, oh, I'm afraid of this animal. I'm going to kill it. That animal probably has the same mentality. Like. I don't like this, so if I'm put into a situation where it's me or him, it's gonna be me.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying, like, discovering a snake or a scorpion or a spider on your face or whatever, flipping out in that particular moment is the worst thing to do. Like, being calm and being like, oh, this thing just doesn't know that I am the alpha of this ecosystem.
I just don't know how you don't naturally, like, you don't just
exactly.
freak out naturally.
You can't smash a spider into your face, because it will die, it will explode, and it will bite you on the eye.
No. I mean, but the thing about bees are a great example. Well, for certain bees, they fear you so much that they are willing to die in their effort to get you out of the picture.
I don't think insects fear.
You don't think so?
I don't think bees do fear you.
Why not?
Because I talk to them a lot. But
apparently bees can smell fear.
I think that they can smell the chemical that is like heightened awareness chemical kind of thing.
Do you think maybe they can smell it because they don't have it?
I think they can. They are on a pheromone track that is basically one bee says enemy and it releases a little spurt of chemical into the air.
Gross.
And every other bee that gets that also releases that same signal.
It sounds like a primitive version of us.
Until it is hive-wide, and then they basically, a single sting is a marker.
Say, kill this.
It actually marks you, and so all of those bees can then see you as like a glowing beacon target.
Kill.
So freaking out around bees... actually the right thing to do.
Run
your balls off. Because standing there and being super calm is just going to get you dead.
R.I.P. Macaulay Culkin, my girl.
Yeah.
That was sad.
Well, let's hope no one's ever seen that movie because you just spoiled it.
Spoiled.
I hope everybody
spoiler alert.
That's what I meant to say.
Yeah. Spoiler alert, Dan Aykroyd.
Go back to the 90s.
Jamie Lee Curtis.
Watch My Girl. It's a great movie. You're going to cry at the end.
Yep.
Yeah.
But not because anybody dies.
No,
by bees.
Not. Definitely not from bee stings.
Probably the number one movie that made you sad when Macaulay Culkin dies. I think the last one on that list is The Good Son.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good Son. Yeah. Don't feel bad at all when that one.
Nope. Spoiler alert.
No. Spoiler alert. He dies.
He's just spoiling all night.
let me see if I can't spoil these early 90s Macaulay Culkin
doesn't the dad push him off an overpass or
probably.
Something?
Probably.
No, it's
brother, stepbrother. It's, or something.
It's the mom. It's Elijah Wood and Macaulay Culkin are both like hanging off a cliff.
Oh, yeah.
And she can only save one of them, so she lets Macaulay Culkin die.
She saves the good son.
She saves the good son.
Mm-hmm. And actually, like, throws a little, like, boom, like, stiff arm.
Oh, no, I can only save one of you.
Have you seen We Need to Talk About Kevin?
Oh, my God, that movie is intense.
No, it's one of those
movies. What the hell of a noise y'all just made?
No, it is such a crazy movie. It's one of those movies where you have to watch it multiple times because you will get a different perspective on it every single time you watch it.
And you really wish that they had talked about Kevin.
Mm. Really, yeah. Because then the whole point of it is you ask yourself, is it... things loose. Mm-hmm. Is it bad parenting or is it a bad seed? That's the debate.
That it's kind of like,
you know, we can discuss that next time because we are out of time.
Oh.
Actually, we're over by like a minute.
Whoa. Well,
yeah. Let's just start the next show.
We were going to stop it at Macaulay Culkin dies in My Girl on a really low note.
Talking about
my girl.
All right.
My girl.
That's it for tonight.
I needed somebody to do that. I needed it to
Thanks,
happen.
Everybody, for coming out. Destiny, it's a great first show for you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
If you like this, like it and share it. Subscribe to our YouTube channel so we can hopefully make eventually some money.
Subscribe.
And then we'll make more of these, and Destiny will come back.
Subscribe.
Yeah.
That's fine. I don't know.
Subscribe.
Yep.
There we go.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
Heart.